Since independence, efforts are being made to take country towards the path of growth, but there have been some lacuna in the growth story, be it be health, education or urban development. However, in the past 9 years, central government has launched some schemes which strengthen and accelerates the commitment of higher inclusive growth. The rural areas lack infrastructure facilities, but with the introduction of Pradhan Mantri Gram Sarak Yojana, the villages are connected with basic amenities, thereby unleashing the growth potential of our villages. This year, the government intended to connect 4,000 villages, but going beyond the set target, about 5,491 villages were connected with all-weather roads. Of the many evils that push back development is illiteracy, and despite significant accomplishments in many sectors, illiteracy continues to be an area of national concern. To tackle this, the Sakshar Bharat Abhiyan was launched with an aim to promote and strengthen adult education, especially of women. But the new India is of youth. More than half of India's total population comprises of young people. In order to give them their rights, many of the government plans are being brought into force. Apart from existing higher educational institutions, as many as 8 new IITs, 7 new IIMs and 16 new central universities have been established. And to provide equal opportunity to the youth of backward, deprived and weaker section, government has started scholarship program for the students for scheduled caste. For the welfare of minorities, Prime Minister's 15-point program is running in right direction. The program aims to ensure that the benefits of various government schemes for the underprivileged reach the disadvantaged sections of the minority communities. The minorities also get 5 lakh rupees of loan, and so far the scheme has spent 1,65,000 crore rupees. Considering the high maternity mortality rate in rural areas, the central government has launched the Janani Shishu Suraksha Yojana. Under this, one-time cash incentive is given to pregnant women for institutional births through skilled assistance. The vaccination program for infants has been lauded by the world. India today is polio-free and is continuously working towards eliminating other diseases by giving free vaccinations for preventing diseases in the newborns. To improve the economic conditions of the rural areas, central government has decided to provide employment opportunities there itself. In this regard, Mahatma Gandhi National Employment Guarantee Scheme was launched. More than 5 crore families have been given employment for 100 days under the scheme. Rural electrification is another major hurdle in the development of rural areas, and therefore to provide electricity to BPL families, Rajiv Gandhi Grameen Vidyuttikaran Yojana was launched. The Bharat Nirman target for Rajiv Gandhi Grameen Vidyuttikaran Yojana was to electrify 1 lakh villages and to provide free electricity connections to 175 lakh BPL households by March 2012, which was achieved by 31st December 2011. Not only this, the central government has also started Jawaharlal Nehru National Urban Renewal Mission for massive city modernization and improve the quality of life and infrastructure in the cities. The telephone which connects the whole country is in the hands of every citizen and has now become a medium of empowerment. In 2007, when only 5 people out of 100 had telephones in villages, today the number has increased, and in 2012, rural telecommunication increased by almost 40%. But still, more has to be done to keep the growth trajectory high and bring back the golden age. With Srijan Srivastava, Manjeet Thakur, DD News.